2016 will be the last full year of the Obama presidency and the president's sixth year in a row working with a Republican Congress. Already, Republicans say they plan to try again to repeal Obamacare. The president's handling of the war on Islamic terrorism, the Guantanamo prison, and Syrian refugees are other expected conflict points. Though there may be more agreement on criminal justice reform and trade treaties. Joining me now from Washington to look ahead at the agenda on Capitol Hill is NewsHour political director Lisa Desjardins. So Lisa, just had your story in the middle of the week about the Do Something Congress. We did get some stuff done on highway transportation funding and making some tax cuts permanent. But as we start the new year, it looks like the repeal of Obamacare will actually land at the president's desk.
So that's right. They're starting with some contention on one of the biggest political issues. But of course, we expect a veto on that. Republicans probably, Hari, will try to pass more repeals. It's good for them in an election year, and it's obviously something they feel strongly about.
What does it look like in terms of things that they do want to get accomplished?
Here is the good news. There are some major pieces of legislation to watch this year. I think the biggest one by far is criminal justice reform. Two reasons I think that we'll see major reform this year, or that it's likely. One is that the way our prison system works right now, Hari, about 2 million prisoners, as you may know, are in American prisons right now. Of those, the vast majority are in state prisons. That's red states and blue states. They're paying $20,000 a prisoner, and that's been crippling state budgets. Red states have been trying to look for a way to reform the system. All that at the same time as there's an increasing recognition that all of these Americans in prison has a long-term devastating effect on families and ultimately on the economy, on education. So wrapping all that up, what that gets us to is a place where some staunch Republicans in Congress, like John Cornyn of Texas, and President Obama in the White House all want to fix the system. They've proposed a bill, Hari, that does a lot of things. Two big points on it. One, it would roll back that three strikes rule, where if you get three strikes, drug crimes, you'll have a mandatory life sentence, cancels that. And the other thing it does is it would review the sentences for most all federal prisoners and allow some of them to spend a quarter of their sentence at home if they're thought to be nonviolent.
All right, and this doesn't happen in a vacuum, as you pointed out. This is an election year. How does that affect the legislative agenda?
Well, actually, I'm going to hold up a little tell here, a little show and tell. This is the House calendar. And the calendar is affected by the election year. There are 4 months that the House will be mostly gone, and that's to run for re-election. Most of July, August, almost all of October and November, lawmakers will not be here. Their primary job this year, as many of them see it, is probably to be reelected. I think we will see them raise some issues, especially Republicans, that they think help them and maybe help their presidential chances. Because, Hari, the Senate is a place that Republicans are a little bit worried. They're concerned that there's a chance that if things go Democrats' way in general, they could lose the Senate. So watch House Speaker Paul Ryan, Hari. Speaking to him and his staff, I know he's going to try and put forth a very serious agenda, perhaps on things like education, healthcare. I don't know that things will be passed, but he wants to try and show that Republicans have policy ideas, which is something that he and I think other leaders are now admitting has been a problem in the past few years.
And what about the prospects for a trade deal that we heard so much about this year?
It's going to be fascinating to watch that, Hari. The president needs a majority vote in both the House and Senate. But already, Senate Leader Mitch McConnell has said he doesn't think that vote could come before the election, maybe not until there's even a new president in office. So that's going to be touch and go, but we're going to watch it closely all year.
All right. The NewsHour's Lisa Desjardins joining us from Washington. Thanks so much.
My pleasure. Happy New Year.